Good morning to all dignitaries, guests, and delegates. With great joy and immense exaltation, I am Dr. Utpala Das, and I feel privileged to welcome you all on behalf of the Tirthankar Mahavir Institute of Management and Technology to the celebration of 12th International Conference on Leadership, Challenges, Issues, and Practices 2021. Well, Dean William R. Inge once said, "The aim of education is the knowledge, not of facts, but of values." It is on such occasions like this, we get opportunities to test our knowledge and understanding. We look forward to get an exposure about what the best of the brains think about this very dynamic issue of leadership, challenges, and practices 2021. Now I invite the dignitaries and special guests to the conference with a request to mark their presence by waving their hands to the audience, participants, and to all those who can't wait to listen to you all. We have with us our special dignitaries, Mr. Raghubir Singh, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Tirthankar Mahavir University, Dr. Aditya Sharma, Honorable Registrar, Tirthankar Mahavir University, Dr. Manjula Jain, Dean Academics, Tirthankar Mahavir University, Dr. Vipin Jain, Director, Tirthankar Mahavir Institute of Management and Technology, Professor Anil Mehta, Banasthali University, Dr. Akhil Mishra, Faculty of Commerce, Varanasi, Dr. Avinash K. Shukla, Associate Dean, Fiji National University, Professor Phool Chandra Jain, former professor at Sampurnanand Sanskrit Vishwavidyalaya, Dr. Kashmir Makul, assistant lecturer, University of South Pacific, Laukala, Suva, Fiji. We begin this beautiful event. For this, may I now invite the person who needs no introduction to set the tone for this occasion by his welcome address. The whole campus is vibrating and echoing his presence. Professor Dr. Vipin Jain is a famous name in the field of commerce and management, a renowned expert of finance and accounting, and having rich and vast experience of research, teaching, and consultancy at national and international level, respectively. Is highly qualified, having a degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Commerce from University of Rajasthan, Jaipur, Cost and Management Accountant from Institute of Cost and Work Accountant of India, and Company Secretary from Institute of Company Secretary of India, LLB from University of Rajasthan, Jaipur, and MBA with gold medal from Rajasthan Technical University, Kota. He has to his credit, publication of 9 books from the areas of commerce and management and accounts, 50 scholarly research papers at national and 10 research papers at international level, published in indexed and refereed journals. He has participated in 30 national and 12 international conferences, seminars, and workshops, organized 12 national and 3 international conferences, and has acted as a resource person in 15 national and 10 national conferences. Currently, he is a professor on management department and director in Tirthankar Mahavir Institute of Management and Technology. He is a multifaceted personality, having a number of assignments and responsibilities at the college level and also at the university level. He is a member of senior management group, academic council, executive council, planning board, research committee, and proctorial board. He is a paper setter and external examiner for many universities and is a member of Senate in various. He's visiting professor for many national. May I now request Dr. Vipin Jain, the director of TIMIT, to welcome the guests. Sir,
I think all the delegates and participants to
mute themselves, please. Thank you very much. I welcome on behalf of Tirthankar Mahavir Institute of Management and Technology to all the delegates, especially our mentor, Professor Raghuveer Singh, Vice Chancellor Mahavir University. Young and dynamic leader, Honorable Registrar Sharma. Professor Manjula, Associate Dean, Mahavir University. Then we have today various speakers on this topic. I firstly welcome Professor Anil Mehta, who is professor in Banasthali University and former professor of University of Rajasthan, Jaipur. I welcome Professor Dr. Akhil Mishra, Faculty of Commerce, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. I also welcome Dr. Avinash Kumar Shukla, Associate Dean, Research, College of Business, Hospitality, Tourism and Studies, Fiji National University, Fiji Islands. Then we have Professor Phoolchand Jain, former Professor Sampurnanand Sanskrit Vishwavidyalaya Varanasi and Emeritus Professor of Genealogy in Tirthankar Mahavir University. Then I would like to welcome Dr. Kashmir Makoon, Assistant Lecturer at the University of South Pacific, Suva, Fiji Islands. Then Dr. Janesh Sami, Assistant Lecturer at the University of South Pacific, Fiji Islands. Then we have, this conference is on title, Leadership, Challenges, Issues and Practices. As this topic is leadership that is very much required in this pandemic situation. And this topic is suggested by our mentor and guide and academic leader, Professor Raghuveer Singh sir. And then we had arranged this conference and we had categorized into three important things. What are the challenges of leadership? What are the issues regarding leaderships? And what are the different practices of leadership? Then we have in this particular conference, four technical sessions. The first technical session will be taken care by external expert, Dr. Janesh Sami from University of South Pacific, Fiji Island, and internal expert, Vibhor Jain from Associate Professor TMIMT. Technical session will be taken care by Professor Phoolchand Jain, former Professor Sampurnanand Sanskrit Vishwavidyalaya and Emeritus Professor of Tirthankar Mahavir University. And it will be internally managed by Dr. Jyoti Puri, Joint Registrar, Research and Development. Then technical session will be taken care by Professor Nimit Gupta, Professor of School of Liberal Studies, NORTHCAP University, Gurgaon, India. And internally, it will be taken care by Dr. Utpala Das, Assistant Professor, TMIMT. Technical session fourth will be taken care by Professor Sunil Gupta, School of Management Studies, Indira Gandhi Open University, New Delhi. And internally, it will be taken care by Ms. Anupama Verma, Assistant Professor, TMIMT. This particular conference is based on leadership. And in this concept, in this particular conference, we will like to learn many things, like what exactly the styles of leadership, what qualities required in leadership, and what are the challenges that come in front of a leader. So I think all the delegates will learn by the speakers who will give their views on this particular topic. As you know, if your action inspires others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, you are a leader. This quote is given by John Quincy Adams. And then the second quotation given by Steve Jobs, innovation distinguishes between a leader and a follower. So there is three important categories under the leadership and three important qualities that required. Leader ke liye teen cheeje aavashyak hain, namrata, spishta aur sahas. Aur Helen Keller ne kaha, akele hum bahut thoda kaam kar sakte hain aur saath mein hum bahut kuch kar sakte hain. And leadership is action, not a position. A quotation given by Doland H. McGannon. In this conference, we received 176 papers from various parts of this world. And out of that, 136 papers are taken consideration for this conference, which will be presented by different presenters virtually on different 4 technical sessions. These papers are thoroughly scanned, properly taken, all the plagiarism and other things are taken into care, and those who got out from all these parameters, those papers are included in this particular conference. And I thank to all the participants, delegates, who had given their consent regarding this conference, and special thanks to our conference convener, Dr. Amit Kansal. Thank you very much. And again, I welcome on behalf of Tirthankar Mahavir University, all the delegates from abroad and from India. Thank you very much for your precious time for this conference. Thank you.
I'm thrilled to mention the name of our next speaker, who's none other than our own vice chairperson, Dr. Raghuveer Singh. When I speak about him, I feel David talking about Goliath. Well, so much to tell about him and his ways through which he keeps inspiring every member of the TMU family. He is none other than the vice chancellor of the TMU, the man of distinct vision and a fountainhead of illuminating ideas, and idol of knowledge and experience and an inspiration to all of us. Professor Raghuveer Singh is currently the Vice Chancellor of Tirthankar Mahavir University, Moradabad. He is a postgraduate in management from Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management, University of Mumbai.
I'll start. Fine, thank you. Thank you so much.
Sir, I have just taken a gist of your
No, that's okay. I think Vice Chancellor of the University, good enough. All of us academicians write some papers, attend some conferences. Let's not repeat something which is obvious. Thank you. Let me start with your permission, if you so say.
Sir, please, we are simply waiting.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Let me on the outset congratulate Dr. Bipin and his team for organizing this conference on leadership challenges, issues. And this is so sought after topic today. And let me also share with you that leadership is the topic which is most researched, most talked about, and most written. You won't get so much of literature on any other topic as you get into a leadership. And also, leadership continues to evolve. If you trace the history of leadership, and as you see today, there is what we call is a flip-flop side, let me put it this way. The leadership as we understand and know today. And when I say leadership, let's time being keep political leadership aside. Right, we'll talk about this a little while, but when we talk about leadership in academic world, a leadership in a business world, it has taken 180 degree turn what it used to be. But there are certain things which are still constant and they will continue to be because they are so essential. Okay, and this pandemic of 2020-21 and 21-22 has given us an immense opportunity to showcase our great leadership skills for the betterment of the society, for the betterment of the humanity. It was a time where people could have shown a lot of compassion, care, empathy, and going out of way to help. This is what, in fact, a leadership is all about. Leadership is not about your authority, which you gain through your positions. And leadership can begin at any point. And leadership can happen at any level. Even it can happen at the lowest level. One need not to be holding a high position to show and express leadership abilities. And we have seen during these 2 years, unknown people have shown a great initiative for the betterment of the society. But unfortunately, there is another aspect which also emerged, and that's on the political arena. So during these periods, we have actually got to know that there are actually two types of truths. The political truth and the real truth. But when you look at the meaning of a truth, it has to be real. But like your gift, the word of truth also changed its meaning. Like today we say a free gift and a gift. If it is a gift, it has to be free. So if it is a truth, it has to be real. But unfortunately, the people who have practiced these words have actually changed the meaning of truth also, which is so unfortunate. Two most important leadership behaviors that emerged during this time. Blame and denial. Deny what others say and blame others for everything else which you could not perform. Right. These were the two important behaviors which emerged. And also, I could see there are two types of leaders who emerged during this period, or rather they shone their characteristics during this period. Ones were self-serving leaders. That was, they all were self-centered. They all talked about themselves or their own parties. And another one was misleading people. They misled the public through so much of discourse that it becomes today difficult to in fact believe who is speaking truth and who is not speaking truth. Similarly, there are, you know, three ways through which people were trying to discharge their responsibility, so-called responsibility. The first one was dishonor. Second was discredit. And third was disdain. You just can imagine the kind of, for last 2 years, the behavior was shown on the national level. And the two broad objectives which emerged during these two, these 2 years, broad objectives of leadership were, one was narrative setting. Okay, set a narrative, whatever way you could. And the second one was create confusion. Now, if this is the kind of a leadership we have at a political arena, which matters for the entire nation, which matters for almost 140 crore people, then God save the Queen. That's the kind of an issue. And that's so unfortunate it is happening. As I was mentioning earlier, the leadership has over a period of time evolved quite a lot. In olden days, when I was studying leadership, it was all about influencing people and having followers. Today, we say the leadership has to go beyond influencing. The leadership has to impact the life of the people. Those whom you lead. And leadership has to add value to all those people whom you're supposed to lead. So I move from influencing to adding value to the people and impacting their life. And as a leader, I need to go beyond impacting the specific people, but I need to impact the life of the community. And through my actions, through my decisions, I need to add value to the community. If that is the kind of leadership activities I do, because as a leader, you need to be very careful that whatever you speak, that is actually converted into actions. And those actions are for the betterment of the people. Also, leadership is all about empowering people, making them capable, helping them to grow, adding value to the people and their life. Else, for them, leadership has no meaning. If I as a leader don't make my people grow, don't add value to their life, I'm not in fact a leader, I'm not performing the role of a leader. Let me be very, very I know outspoken on this aspect. I'm not supposed to perform my task in a circular fashion. I'm supposed to assure that there is a spiral movement, not only to organization, but to my people. My people move to the next orbit. That's the role of a leader. Now, you must have come across different types of leaders. The leader who builds the future of an organization, that means someone who prepares the organization for future, is the leader who can succeed in all kinds of situations. A leader who works in the present cannot impact the future of an organization. But yes, his performance in the future can influence, but unless he sees the future and prepares the organization according to the future, the organization cannot sustain its success for longer. And today, when we talk about any organization's success, we in fact talk about its sustenance, whether it can sustain for a long time or not. Leaders are supposed to be displaying goal-oriented behavior. That means they need to do everything that is required to achieve their goals. So I as a leader, supposed to do what my goal demands, nothing beyond it. So my focus is my goal. And I know when I have to achieve my goal, it's my people who will help me achieve my goal. So as an individual, I'm supposed to take care of my people. And then the people take care of everything else in the organization. A lot of us, in fact, look for perfect situation. A lot of us have a tendency, not only as a leader, but as a human being also, a perfect situation. Let's appreciate the fact that God has not created a perfect world. So let's not expect perfect people. A perfect husband, perfect wife, perfect parents, perfect employees, perfect leader, perfect organization. No, there's nothing called perfect. We need to learn to embrace the reality. What it is. And work with that. You know, a lot of leaders, in fact, tend to complain. I don't have a great subordinates. I don't have people which can help me to, accomplish my objectives. But one need to realize that what you have are the best, and you got to do with them. You got to achieve with them. You got to take them along. You got to develop them as a team. Nobody else is going to do it for you. And as a leader, you must realize, please, that don't wait for something to happen. Whether it is at home, at the society, or in organization, it's you who will make it happen. If you believe you can make it happen, it will surely happen. Nobody else is going to come to help us or do all that for us. My advice to my subordinates is, it is a tendency of human being to get perfected at what one does, what one do every day, or what one practices every day. So as a leader, that means if you are growing or intend to be a leader in the future, please understand and learn what kind of characteristics and behavior is accepted or expected from a leader. Start practicing that. And if you practice that behavior, you will get perfected at that behavior. There are sure disasters for leader. If one, practices a behavior such as self-centered. Self-centered behavior is a short for disaster as a leader. Okay. Someone who fears to do something new. That means he lacks courage and confidence. A leader is supposed to have a lot of courage to move into uncharted territory. And one cannot move on a spiral way or grow spirally unless otherwise one move to an uncharted territory. If you continue to do same thing over and over again and expect different results, I think one is in fool's paradise. If you want to achieve different results, you have no choice but to do differently. So that's what we say, you have to move to the uncharted path. If you have lack of empathy, lack of integrity, you have a directive behavior, if you are highly impatient with people or for results, I think you cannot succeed as a leader. That's what my take on leadership is all about. Over a period of time, we have learned different leadership styles, and many new leadership styles have emerged. You know, people do ask, you know, when you interact with, okay, what kind of leadership style do you have? Now, it's very difficult to answer this question, what leadership style one has. I don't think there is a single leadership style any one of us have. I would rather recommend or rather suggest that we all are on a continuum of leadership. You know, and even that continuum of an individual varies depending upon the situation. So there is nothing called a fixed leadership behavior. Unlike human behavior, it will be risky to predict anyone's leadership style. And if someone can predict one's leadership style, I think one needs to rethink on his style of leadership. Because the way you will deal with issues will depend upon various perspectives, nature, conditions of that particular issue. There are no fixed styles as such. But there are certain recommendatory ones. Like today people talk about authentic leadership. Authentic leadership. That means someone who builds honest relationship, not the relationship which is based upon based upon someone's motives or based upon advantages which you are seeking from a relationship, and have built a strong trust in his or her team. These are the two important characteristics of an authentic behavior. And he is someone who is genuine, have a transparent ways of operating. Transparency and genuineness is two most important characteristics, another two most important characteristics of an authentic leader, and got to have a very high integrity. There is no way that one can perform to be a good leader without integrity, and one follows his value system. That means, as I mentioned earlier, one should not be predictable in his style, but one should be predictable by his value system. The entire lot of the people who are under your influence should understand your value system. And people would understand your value system through your character. That means the way you display them, not the way you speak about them. The people are very discerning today. You know, when you say that you mean this, when you say that I care my people, no, that's good enough, but they would deduce it from how much time, effort, and resources you are putting for the caring of people. So you see, the deduction come from there. So all your actions as a leader should show that behavior which you are trying to reflect on the people. Then you have something called a servant leadership. Over a period of time, you must have heard about, you know, some of the great names of servant. This is not a new concept, it's been there, but somehow it has not come to the forefront in olden days, especially in business or academic world. Servant leadership is one who actually works for others. That means others are the focus of my efforts. You know, I'm not a self-centered guy. I work for them. So people like Martin Luther, people like Mahatma Gandhi, they practice that servant leadership. That means others are first, not me as an individual. They are the people who acknowledge others' perspective. That is what exactly their needs are. What their thinking is, they appreciate that. That's a servant leadership. You must also heard about shepherd leadership. You know, shepherd leader is one who always remains behind his flock. You know, that means he allows his people to hog all the limelight of good performance of the organization. He allows them to take all the credit. He allows them to undertake challenging tasks. He creates opportunity for them to go ahead, and he watches from behind. So the issue is, when I say shepherd leadership, is it leading from behind or leading from the front? That's the next natural question which comes. Now, again, I won't speak about that, which one is should be given importance. I'd say it depends upon the situation. If you are following a shepherd leadership or a servant leadership, then you identify occasions when you have to lead from the front, and you identify occasions when you have to lead from the back. If it is all about taking credit, hogging limelight, you stay back, lead from the back. But if it is troubles, challenges, showing new way, bringing new dimension to the organization, lead from the front. You want to bring change, lead from the front. So it will depend upon what is the in fact occasion, what is the situation that should decide whether you would lead from front or from the behind, not what is your style. It cannot be a fixed style. Then of course we've been talking about styles like situational, autocratic, participant. You know, participative as such is not a style, it's basically a decision-making process. A lot of people tend to say participative leadership is more of a chaotic one. No, I have my opinion that it's not the style is not chaotic, it's the leader who makes it chaotic. A leader should know for what participation is required, to what level the participation is required, and when and where to close the participation and take a call. If you know about this, this leadership style can never become chaotic. And there is something called transformational leadership versus transactional leadership. Well, when it comes to say, it'll be easy for all of us to understand this leadership style in academic world. When an academic leader emphasizes on completing course and completing examinations in time and declaring results, that's a transactional leadership. Or one who is involved in what I generally tend to call a circular way of doing things, day in and day out. And if a leader tries to break away from that circle and moves to the spiral way through his interventions, through his change management, through his visualization, and taking along all his people, improving his people, empowering his people, all that becomes transformational leadership. You can go on talking about leadership. I think I will leave this stage now and provide opportunity to my other invited guests to deliberate on these issues, and I'm sure by end of the day we'll find a lot of new aspects issues emerge for all of us. And I'll request Dr. Vipin to compile all these views and circulate among us so that we all get benefited from numerous experts which you have for this conference. Thank you so much for giving me time and a patient hearing. Thank you. Dhanyavad and all the best.
Thank you, sir.
Madam, unmute yourself. Vipin, madam, go unmute kare. Haan, abhi.
Thank you very much, sir. This is yet another great learning session from you. Thank you very much. I am profusely elated to take an opportunity to introduce our next guest of the day, Professor Akhil Mishra from Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. Dr. Akhil Mishra is a Faculty of Commerce, BHU, Varanasi. He has teaching experience of over 28 years. He's been a gold medalist in the University of Allahabad and has served as a lecturer in Arunachal University, Garhwal University. To him goes the credit of publishing more than 40 papers and has written 2 books on financial accounting. Dr. Mishra is a member of advisory board of Indian Journal of Commerce, IAA, Varanasi branch, secretary, chairperson in the last IAA conference in Jodhpur. He has chaired many sessions and conferences and seminars, keynote speakers in several conferences. He has been also an ex-student advisor of NSS officer, administrative warden in BHU. On behalf of the management, I request him to deliver the speech and enlighten all of us. Sir, please.
Thank you, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, very much.
Okay. Namaskar to all of you. In 12th International Conference on Leadership Challenges, Issues and Practices 2021 being organized by PMI MP under the aegis of Tirthankar Mahavir Nasri Moradabad. Respected Professor Raghuveer Singh, Vice Chancellor TMU, Dr. Aditya Sharma, Registrar, Dr. Manjula Jain, Associate Dean TMU, Professor Anil Mehta of Banastra University, Dr. Avnish Kumar Shukla, Associate Dean Research, PG National University, he happens to be my student also, Professor P. Jain sir, Emeritus Professor, and other dignitaries of the inaugural session. I welcome to all of you in this session, and very good topic has been chosen for today's conference, that is leadership, which is very debatable, very disputed, and very critical to decide what when to say this is good leadership, when to say it's a bad leadership. Since myself is Dr. Akhil Mishra, Professor of Commerce and Management, Faculty of Commerce, Banaras Hindu University, Kashi Hindu Vishwavidyalaya. Since I hail from Kashi Hindu Vishwavidyalaya, though it will be very inappropriate if I do not remember my founder, Bharat Ratna Mahamana Pandit Madan Mohan Malviji Maharaj, who happened to be a great leader, great social leader, great educational leader, great financial leader, great legal leader, I can say, jinhone as a social leader kaha, na toham kamme rajyam, na swargam, na punarbhuvam, kamme dukh taptanam, daninama vinashinam, na tu mujhe rajyam kamna, na tu mujhe swarg ki kamna, na tu mujhe punarjan ki kamna, meri to bas ek hi kamna hai, ki main hamesha दुखी लोगों का की मदद करता रहूं, सहायता करता रहूं। एज ए फाइनेंशियल लीडर उनका एक ये वक्तव्य बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है, मर जाऊं मांगू नहीं अपने तन के काज, बर मारत के कारणे मोह न आवे लाज। एज ए फाइनेंशियल लीडर ही हैज डेवलप्ड सच ए ग्रेट डायनेस्टी व्हिच इज वेल रिनोन्ड इन ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड नोन एज काशी हिंदू विश्वविद्यालय। उन्होंने विद्यार्थियों के लिए भी एक लीडरशिप दी, सत्येन ब्रह्मचर्यिन व्यामिनार्थ विद्या देशभक्त्या आत्मत्यागेन सदा समनार भवा। ऐसे महामना को हम याद करते हुए वी आई वांट टू एम आई ऑडिबल
यस सर लाउड एंड क्लियर।
नाउ तो उनको याद करते हुए मैं लीडरशिप पे आई वांट टू डिस्कस सम ऑफ माय व्यूज रिगार्डिंग लीडरशिप। लीडरशिप इज ए एबिलिटी टू इंस्पायर, इट्स एन एबिलिटी, एवरीवन डू नॉट हैव सच काइंड ऑफ एबिलिटी, इट्स इनबॉर्न एबिलिटी रेदर आई से, इट इज एबिलिटी टू इंस्पायर, इट्स ए पावर टू इन्फ्लुएंस, इट्स ए क्वालिटी टू डायरेक्ट, इट्स ए फोर्स टू परसुएट, इट्स ए पावर टू क्रिएट कॉन्फिडेंस। इफ सच ट्रेट्स आर देयर, सच एबिलिटीज आर देयर, then we can say he may be a person, may be a kind of leader, and in our Mahamana all such abilities were very much present in him at his time. It's a further leadership is a composite internal but personal, then it's a process to influence the behavior. If you are not in a position to influence the behavior, then it has no leadership, has no meaning, and leadership must have followers, and it is always, it may be sometime situational also, and it's always goal or task oriented. After a long gap, we are having very prominent leaders as a our honorable prime minister Narendra Modi sir, jinme hum netritv ke mahan gun dekhte hain aur unki har baat ko aaj har nagrik manne ko tatpar bhi hai, iske hum keh sakte hain unme good leadership hai. A leader is one who guides and directs others. Leader hota hai जो दूसरों को गाइड करता है, गाइड करता है, या हमारे कॉमर्स एंड मैनेजमेंट में हम कहते हैं गेटिंग द थिंग्स डन बाय अदर्स। इफ वी आर डूइंग द थिंग्स देन इट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, इफ वी आर अलाउइंग अदर्स, गिविंग द अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू अदर टू डू द वर्क, देन इट्स ए रियल पार्ट ऑफ लीडरशिप, और वी कैन से इट्स ए रियल पार्ट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। एंड वी सिंस बीइंग ए स्टूडेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड मैनेजमेंट, वी जनरली टॉक अबाउट कॉर्पोरेट लीडरशिप, since because we are a part of corporate management, in that context one scholar has said leadership is vital to the survival of a business. If in a business leadership is there, then it can survive, otherwise it cannot survive in this competitive world. And we all know that our corporate world is very sophisticated, and the real person, the real member, person who works for the organization is the manager. And he is not a leader, but he has to work as a leader to give the vision, to give the shape to the organization in the competitive world. And yani leadership provides is a, such a catalyst. By having good leadership, employees feel motivated, they get a kind of vision, they have a spirit of teamwork, they can go for effective utilization of resources and having higher morale within the organization. As far as the styles of leadership are concerned, basically three bases are there: authority basis, motivation basis, orientation basis. On the basis of authority, we may have autocratic leadership, democratic leadership, free-reign leadership. Free-reign leadership is very generous and very difficult to implement within the organization. As far as autocratic, democratic styles are concerned, there may be autocratic, democratic, autocratic in planning, democratic in implementation. There may be democratic, autocratic, democratic in planning, autocratic in implementation. There may be democratic, democratic, democratic in planning, democratic in implementation, and autocratic, autocratic means autocratic in planning and autocratic in implementation. These are the basis on the basis leadership styles on the basis of authority. Then on the basis of motivation, we have two kinds of leadership style: positive leadership, negative leadership. Positive leadership has efficiency oriented, rewards oriented. These rewards may be monetary or non-monetary. Likewise, further negative motivation is based on penalties and punishment. And in this way, the leaders want to have get the work done by the others. And then lastly, basis orientation. On the basis of orientation, we may have production-oriented leadership, we may have employee-oriented leadership. Production-oriented leadership is based on production capacity, employee-oriented leadership is based on employees' betterment, and if employees are satisfied, definitely production will be also as far as traits of leaders are concerned, which is very important. We may have leadership ability, quality in us, but if these traits are not within us, then there is nothing about leadership. But regarding traits, ability, one must have ability. If ability is there, then he may be a leader. Then second part is courage. Every leader must have courage. A jump has to be taken. Everyone says we can jump, he can jump, I can jump. But when it is to the time it comes to take jump, no, everyone differs. No, what's the use of jumping? When time will come, I will jump. So courage is not there. Courage must be there within the leader. Then willpower. Mahamana jaisa willpower hona bahut avashyak hai. Kuch nahi tha unke paas. Unhone sankalp liya ki hum Kashi Hindu Vishwavidyalaya banayenge aur banaya, mang mang kar banaya, har vyakti se manga aur ek aisa vishwavidyalaya diya jiski aaj hum kalpana nahi kar sakte. Aaj ke yug mein hum itna bada vishwavidyalaya, itna sundar vishwavidyalaya bana nahi paaye hain. Aur jab unhone zameen mangi thi Kashi Naresh Maharaj se, to unhone has kar kaha tha ki jao din bhar jitna chaloge itni zameen tumhari ho jayegi. Mahamana ne chalna shuru kiya, chalte chalte itna chale ki sham ko jo harkaron ne bataya ki Mahamana itna chale hain, to Kashi Maharaj Naresh ji ekdam aashchakit ho gaye. Ek vyakti itna kaise chal sakta hai, tum mazak karte ho kya? Bola nahi, unhone Maharaj itna hi chale hain aur Mahamana ko utni zameen unhone di. Aur chale kaisa? Ardhachandrakar chale. Agar aap Google par dekhen, it's a semi protector shape. Is shape mein Mahamana us zamane mein, us jungle mein chale jahan aaj hum is vishwavidyalaya mein व्यवस्थित व्यवस्थाओं में पैदल चलना मुश्किल हो जाता है हमारा. उस जंगल में महामना साहब, क्योंकि इनमें क्या था, विल पावर थी कि उन्हें करना है. जजमेंट होना चाहिए लीडरशिप में, जजमेंट एबिलिटी बहुत तगड़ी होनी चाहिए, फिट होना चाहिए, फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी होनी चाहिए. एडमेंसी नहीं होनी चाहिए कि एक पर्टिकुलर निर्णय हो गया था बस उसी पर हम अटक गए. नो, फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी. अगर जैसे मोदी साहब हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर, बहुत फ्लेक्सिबल लीडर है. समस्याएं आई, एक निदान आया, नहीं संभव, तुरंत दूसरा निदान कोशिश करते हैं, तो दूसरा सोल्यूशन वर्कआउट कर लेते हैं. नॉलेज होना बहुत जरूरी है, इंटीग्रिटी होना बहुत जरूरी है, सोशियबिलिटी होना बहुत जरूरी है, डोमिनेंस भी होना बहुत जरूरी. लीडरशिप में डोमिनेंस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इफ डोमिनेंस इज देयर, एनीथिंग कैन बी डन. देन आफ्टर ऑल सर्जेंसी मस्ट बी देयर. द लीडर शुड बी वेरी टॉकेटिव, वेरी मैनिपुलेटिव, चीयरफुल, एंथुसियास्टिक, फुल ऑफ एंथुसियास्म, एक्सप्रेसिवनेस. What he wants to say, it must be expressed very clearly to each and every follower. And alertness, he must